What is going on YouTube and welcome back to another video, and today we are reacting to Kim Dracula 70 Thorns featuring Jonathan Davis of Korn. Say that five times fast. I really don't think I can. I've heard this is a really great band and that they are one of the bands to watch in 2023, so I'm super stoked to hop into this. But before we begin, do me a favor and smash that thumbs up button and subscribe. 98% of our viewers are not subscribed, so to the 2% of you that are, I appreciate you. But to everybody else, what you waiting for? But anyways, let's hop into it. Interesting. We got some flute in here. That's what metal bands have been missing this entire time, is a solid flute player. I have a feeling this is going to get really weird really fast. Yo, that high note was respect. Okay. What the fuck just happened? This is great. I love it. You don't know what to expect next. In the hurt, believe hurt, at least 20 people take turns to speak. I'm sick of feeling like I'm a villain in the first degree. Stick will make your fingers up, flip it to God. I don't do anybody, you gotta kick up your job. That's the one that I just put him in, they take him away. I wanna see about other buckets and better, but sound about a different way. I wanna feel something. So many tempo changes, I love it! This is like, I don't even know. It's like a circus on acid with a jazz band. I love it. All right, so where do I begin here? I'm trying really hard to gather my thoughts after that. I mean, first of all, that was awesome. I fucking loved it. I loved everything about it. It started off with like a jazz band and we're skit-scatting and we've got the wind instrument. I don't know if it's a flute or a clarinet. Somebody's going to correct me in the comments, so tell me. First person to comment what that was in the beginning actually gets the comment pinned for the video. And you can insult me however you want for not knowing. But we go to that. We get a crazy power metal high, some fast guitar riffs, really up-tempo, really upbeat, just power thrash metal, and it was great. And then we go down the rabbit hole, and my man starts doing some crazy vocals. I'm not sure if they were fries, or squeals, or a mixture of everything, but it was crazy, and I mean, I liked it. And I got a really Jonathan Davis-esque vibe from the noises he was making, which I loved. Then we got heavy, chaotic, got Jonathan Davis in for the chorus that kind of toned it down. Like, I never thought I'd say Jonathan Davis' part in a song is the most mellow part of a song, but it was, and it was good. It was catchy, it brought you in. And then holy mother of breakdowns, that breakdown came out of nowhere. And then I take back what I said. I take back what I said about that's what metal's been missing is, you know, a flute player. A horn player is what's been missing. Horns in the breakdowns. Every metal band, that's the new meta. Put a horn in your breakdown, please. But I mean, all in all, that was a journey. That was a crazy experience. I almost felt like, you know, I did some hallucinogenic drug and went on a spirit journey through that song. But it was incredible, and I'm a fan of it. And I'm definitely going to be checking out more Kim Dracula. So Kim Dracula fans, tell me what song I need to react to next. What is your favorite Kim Dracula song? Drop it in the comments and I will be checking more of them out. But anyways, that's going to be it for today's video. If you like the content, make sure to smash the thumbs up button, subscribe. And I feel like I need to go take a hot shower after listening to that. But anyways, we'll see you next time.